been running around. But I'll tell you, listen, I don't care what you was in the world, once you get saved, He renewed you. So you got a renewed body. He bring back your youth. He bring things back together. So you ain't all sloppy and everything. So they be on television telling girls how to exercise. You ain't got to do that. That's crazy. But you get in the law. Mother, I saw it, you lie. I look at mothers how they're used to. I said, because they've been kept back up. I tell them, I said, a church that sits is not helpful. But if you give God a praise, He get the blood. Go to those knees. The blood go through the joints. And you find yourself begin to move. That's why I talk about girls. I said, get up and praise Him. I said, get up and give God. Because it's pumping. And when I praise God, I'm putting the devil under my feet. And I'm praising Him. I'm telling God to put the devil under my feet. When I praise Him, I'm asking Him to bring me out. God, I need You to be my weaponry. I need You to get me out of this. I remember a time we were getting the services, and the service would get so high, people would leave and they had to turn to the car. Do y'all remember that? To see those days come back when you can have revival. That's why I love it when I see all of y'all unite together, because now folks don't want a fellowship, but they scared that they, people gonna leave their ship and go over to another ship. Now if I'm your friend, I'm ready to close it out. Coming from St. Mark 16. If I'm your friend and I'm in fellowship with you, and your member, we in fellowship, and you done seen them sitting up in my church, then they gonna go run over to yours. First thing you ought to see them, you see them the first Sunday. God bless you, you came to visit me. Then you see him on the second Sunday, say, oh, what's going on with this? Then the third Sunday, you have to call the pastor. Say, Bishop, I don't know what's going on, but I see Sister So-and-so, one of your members, been coming. And then you need to tell him, say, baby, what's going on with you? See, that's the way I do. And I find out what's wrong with him. One of the young men said, I didn't like what my pastor did. I said, who are you to not like what your pastor did? I just want to be with y'all. Y'all, I said, no. I go back home. Because I realize if I take you, that same spirit that you had over there, after a while, somehow I might say will make you run me. Hallelujah. But people don't do that no more. Well, the Lord told me to accept whoever want to be. No. Because you have to make sure they leave it in good standards. Should be leaving in good standards. Somebody, one of our friends calls it, one of your members is over in my church. My husband said, well, maybe you can do something with it. It's all right. Hallelujah. But I just, we didn't do that. We fellowship with churches. We didn't run the each other churches. We went in our leaders' group. And we didn't stay afterwards talking to them. What you got to say to the pastor? You got no business but saying the only thing you should say, praise the Lord. You ain't on another. So when I talk like this, people don't like this kind of talk. But it's true. I believe this is holiness. This is how we preach in holiness. And folks is getting away from this type of preaching. But I'm bringing it on in. You're going to read the scripture so they won't say we didn't give them a scripture.